हेलो सी आई एस स्कॉलर्स, वेलकम बैक टू आर इंग्लिश ग्रामर वर्ल्ड। एंड इन प्रीवियस वीडियो वी ऑलरेडी फिनिश्ड वर्ब्स, राइट? वी ऑलरेडी फिनिश्ड वर्ब्स एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, ऑक्सिलरी वर्ब्स, राइट? सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। यस स्कॉलर्स, ऑक्सिलरी वर्ब, दिस वर्ब can also be called as helping verbs, okay? Or we can say that helping verbs synonym is auxiliary verb, okay? So what is auxiliary verb? Auxiliary verb means the verb which helps the main verbs in any sentence. That's why it's called as auxiliary or helping verb. Means what is the correct definition? That auxiliary verbs are also called as helping verbs because they help the main verb in a sentence. Auxiliary verbs also includes modals. Now what is this model? Okay, modals are different topic that we will discuss, but first of all, that what is auxiliary verb? A verb which helps main verbs in any sentence. Okay, there will be main verb, but the verb which helps that main verb to give a meaningful sentence, to make a meaningful sentence, that verb can be called as auxiliary verbs. Okay, and this auxiliary verbs are divided into three parts. First one is the group in which is, am, are, was, were, this helping verbs come, that group is B group. Okay, B group. Next one is do. Do, does, don't. And these three we are not going to discuss now because in your grammar textbook this is not given. Okay, so in next class maybe you have to study about this do, does, don't. Okay, so we are going to discuss about is, am, are, was, were, and the next one, have, has, had. Okay, so we have to discuss auxiliary verbs. This is, am, are, was, were. You have to remember, scholars, you have to remember all these helping verbs. Okay, because these are helping the main verbs in any sentence. Okay, this is, am, are, was, were, have, has, had. Okay, yes. Next is modals. Now what are modals? Modals give additional information about the function of the main verb that follows it. Okay, modals can be used, modals can be used to give additional information about the function of the main verb. Means what is the function of the main verb? Verb means action word, right? And that action word is doing its work in the sentence, but to give more information or to add information about that function, modals can be used. Okay, I will explain you with example. First let's see that what words can be used as modals. So these are the words: can, could, may, might, shall, should, must, will, would, all these are modals. Okay, so these are the words, these are the words which are in right column, these are the words which can be used as modals, and these are the words which can be used as auxiliary verbs. Okay, so you have to understand the difference between auxiliary verbs and modals, because sometimes in question it's given to use only auxiliary verbs and sometimes it's given to use only modals. So in the place of these modals we cannot use auxiliary verbs. Okay, yes, the important thing is in the auxiliary verb am is also an auxiliary verb. Okay, it's written here, see, right? So the auxiliary verb am is used only with I. It should be used only with I, not with any other subject. Okay, yes. Now let's move ahead. Okay, now there are some tips by which you can use auxiliary verbs at the correct place. Okay, let's see. Singular auxiliary verbs. See scholars, you have to remember one thing, that on the basis of what we have to use auxiliary verbs. So हम कैसे कहीं पे auxiliary verb on किस base पे हम use करते हैं. So we can use auxiliary verbs with the in reference of subject. Okay, subject and verb agreement should be there. Means if subject is singular, then we have to use singular verbs. Okay, and if subject is plural in any sentence, then we have to use plural auxiliary verbs. Okay, see here I wrote some examples of, not some examples, these are the verbs, these are the auxiliary verbs which can be used as a singular auxiliary verbs. Okay, is, was, am, has. Okay, these are the verbs which can be used as singular auxiliary verbs. Like for example, he is playing, right? He is playing. So here he is a subject and he means singular, any one, right? Any one boy is playing, not his friends also. So he is singular subject, and with this singular subject I added here singular auxiliary verb, right? He is playing. And see scholars, playing is the main verb. Okay, what the subject is doing? Subject is playing, but this auxiliary verb is just helping this main verb to give a complete sense, right? So you have to understand this thing, and you have to remember that singular auxiliary verbs should be used with singular subject, right? So there should be subject verb agreement, right? Now let's see plural auxiliary verbs. So these are the examples of plural auxiliary verbs. Are, were, have, these are the examples of plural auxiliary verbs, and this should be used with plural subject. Okay, for example, boys are playing. Here I'm not talking about any one boy, I'm talking about boys. So boys means plural subject. With plural subject I added are auxiliary verb, because are is example of plural auxiliary verb, right? So boys are playing. Okay, you have to remember these tips. Next is auxiliary verb used in present tenses. Okay, when we have to use these auxiliary verbs in present tense, at that time we have to use only these auxiliary verbs: is, am, are, has, have. We cannot use had in place of has, because has is showing present tense. Okay, have is showing present tense, means all these words can be used only in present tense. All these words means these helping verbs or these auxiliary verbs are used in present tenses. Okay, and these auxiliary verbs means was, were, had, these three auxiliary verbs can be used with past tense. Okay, so you have to remember this all points, means singular auxiliary verbs, plural auxiliary verbs, subject verb agreement, and the verbs which are used in present tense and the verbs which are used in past tense. Okay, yes, and the most important thing, a verb must agree with its subject in number and person. ओके, कैसा अग्रीमेंट चाहिए, जो सब्जेक्ट है वो कितना है नंबर में, एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट वी हैव टू ऐड हेल्पिंग वर्ब. ओके, इफ इट्स इन सिंगुलर वी हैव टू ऐड सिंगुलर ऑक्सिलरी वर्ब, एंड इफ सब्जेक्ट इज इन प्लूरल वी हैव टू ऐड प्लूरल ऑक्सिलरी वर्ब्स. ओके, लेट्स मूव अहेड. सी स्कॉलर्स, दिस इज वन पिक्चर विच आई टुक फ्रॉम अनदर टेक्स्ट बुक, एंड this is just for your reference. If you want to learn, if you want to read more about auxiliary verbs and models, you can see from here. Here it's rules are given that when to use all these models. Okay, when to use all these models, there should be possibility. One even examples are also given. This is just for your reference, and you can see. Okay, let's move ahead. This is the last exercise of the chapter verbs. Okay, page number 62. Choose the correct helping verb. Helping verb means auxiliary verbs from the options given in the brackets and fill in the blanks. So what we have to do, we have to put here helping verbs. See, you have to pay attention, we have to put here helping verbs. Okay, Jerry dash gone to the gymnasium. Okay, so what will come here? Jerry is a singular subject, so what will come? Has. Okay, let's see any other example. Seventh one, she dash leave for Tokyo on Friday. She is singular, but we are talking about future. She dash leave for Tokyo on Friday, not today, on Friday. She will leave for Tokyo on Friday. Okay, yes. Now next, let's move ahead. Yes, this is the first exercise of the chapter auxiliary verbs. Okay, why we are doing all these three chapters together? Because these all three chapters are interrelated with each other. Okay, this exercise was given on page number 63. What is the question here? Fill in the blanks with shall, have, was, were, have, shall be, will be, is, am, has, had, or will have. So many examples, so many options are there. Okay, so you have to pay attention while filling these blanks. The boy dash going to the market to make some purchase. The boy. Okay, the boy means about some about one particular boy we are talking here, and that particular boy means singular subject. Okay, so the boy is going to the market to make some purchase. Okay, let's see one more example. Fourth one we will see. The team players dash too exhausted to perform any further. The team players means this subject is plural. Okay, so with plural, what we have to add? With plural we have to add plural auxiliary verb, means were. Why not are, why were? Because this sentence is in past tense. Past tense, why? Because this here TED with verb we added ED, means the team players were too exhausted to perform any further. This sentence was happened. Okay, that's why we wrote here verb. So scholars, in the same way, first you have to understand auxiliary verbs, then models, and where to use. You have to remember all that tips, and by reading your textbook, by listening this video, by watching this video, you can solve all these sentences by yourself. So try to do this, and in next video we will continue the same chapter. Till that time, take care. Bye bye.